This is Fatu. Scientists are inserting a 2-meter-long device into the female rhino to collect her immature egg cells. Fatu and her mother Najin are kept under guard 24 hours a day because they are the only 2 northern white rhinos left in the world. The window to keep their species from going functionally extinct to fully extinct is closing fast. And there's just one last glimmer of hope: artificial reproduction. But how does this work? A rhino's life mission has always been peaceful: to eat plants and reproduce. Without many predators, they flourished for millions of years. But humans put an end to that by hunting them down and destroying their habitat. One rhino species in particular is doing worse than all the others: the northern white. In 2008, the IUCN officially declared the northern white rhino to be extinct in the wild. Now, there are just 2 females left: Fatu and Najin. But a group of experts have created a plan to bring their species back from extinction. The leader of the International Biorescue Project is Professor Thomas Hildebrandt from the Leibniz Institute for Zoo and Wildlife Research. Biorescue's artificial reproduction is now the last glimpse of hope for the northern white rhino. But let's start at the beginning. Around 50 years ago, poachers began illegally hunting thousands of rhinos across Africa for their horns. This, combined with civil wars and habitat loss, decimated the northern white rhino population. Conservationists were concerned and began to breed them in captivity in the 1970s. This involved collecting and storing semen from different males. Only a few rhinos were ever born through the breeding program. The last 2, Najin and her daughter Fatu, have become famous. Sadly, neither of them can have a calf. Najin's hind legs are too weak, and Fatu has a degenerated uterine lining. On top of that, the worst possible scenario happened. Sudan, the last male northern white rhino, died in 2018. This left no living males and no females able to carry a pregnancy, and so the species was deemed functionally extinct. But Thomas Hildebrandt and his team are doing the unthinkable and creating viable embryos in the lab. It all starts with the extraction of immature eggs.
Our patient is nearly 2 tons, and that means the ovaries are quite far inside the body of this rhino. We had to develop a totally new approach. It is a device which is inserted into the rectum. Then we go in about 2 meters through the rectum and find then the ovaries which are deep inside the abdominal cavity. And then we have to use a needle which is bended about 80 degrees. So we actually shoot around the corner to aspirate the follicles.
The reproduction laboratory Avantia, which is also part of the Biorescue Consortium, perfected a technique for creating viable embryos from these egg cells. On August 22, 2019, Najin and Fatu's eggs were extracted and flown to this lab. 3 days later, the eggs were fertilized with preserved sperm from male northern white rhinos. After another week, 2 of the eggs had made it to the stage of development, when the embryo can be frozen and preserved for the future. In 2019 and 2020, 3 more embryos were created, bringing fresh hope that the species could be saved from extinction. So, at the moment there are a total of 5 pure northern white rhino embryos in the world. They are stored in liquid nitrogen.
To freeze an embryo for a long term, you have to stop any life function. So you have to freeze it instantly to a level that there's no metabolic activity, no enzyme is active. And that means minus 196 degrees Celsius. And they can store it in liquid nitrogen for more than 100 years.
The next step is to find promising surrogate mothers. Northern and southern white rhinos diverged about 1 million years ago into separate, though still closely related species. They inhabit different regions and have slightly different physical traits. But pregnancy is the same length for both of them. And so researchers are optimistic that a southern white rhino can carry a northern white rhino embryo to term. The Biorescue team hopes to be able to deliver its first northern white rhino calf soon.
Internally discussed, the early start would be maybe possible at the end of this year. We want to produce a calf as soon as possible so that the social knowledge or the experience Najin and Fatu have can be transferred, can be taught.
The scientists think they can collect Fatu's eggs for the next 5 years, but they aren't sure about Najin. She's already 32 and also has a tumor. It's a race against time.
The goal is actually to repair some of the severe mistakes the human population have done a few decades ago by causing the extinction of this charismatic two-ton heavy animal, which was the dominant species in this swamp area in Central Africa. The rhino didn't fail in evolution. It is not a process that a species gets extinct because it is not more adapted to the environmental factors. It is only not bulletproof because the people shot it. We have the responsibility as scientists to fix some of these severe mistakes, and I think it is really important that science can be used to make our planet better for the next generation.
More and more species will be on the brink of extinction. And Biorescue's work is not only important for rhinos, but for many more species. We want to shed light on such important conservation work, and by watching our videos, you are helping us to reach that goal. Be sure to subscribe, because there's much more to come.